to our creativity zone where Anita Harpley created me.
Hi, on today's Polymer Clay journey, kind of more of a come learn with me. Not really a tutorial because this was all brand new for me. I've never made a small aquarium out of a coffee jar before. I wanted to come up with a unique birthday gift for my dad. My dad drinks coffee out of this particular, I think it's Nescafe instant coffee. So he's been giving them to me as he's completed them. I mix some sand and glitter and Mod Podge and tried to get every last drop into this tall jar. Once I began, I started to realize this adventure was going to be tricky trying to work in a tall jar, especially since I cannot lift my arms very well. But hey, it was something fun to do and a great learning experience that I just want to share in case you're inspired to even try something like this. I've seen some videos where people make like miniature little aquariums, which are amazing. And I don't know how much patience they have because this was probably about 6 to 7 inches tall. So it's more of a little aquarium, faux aquarium, with epoxy resin. So you'll need some of that if you want to try this. I laid down real seashells before it dried, and then I tilted the jar to kind of dry at an angle so that it would be more interesting, kind of thinking that the seashore would be a little, I don't know, just not flat. I let it dry for 2 to 3 days. I actually lost track, and it still never dried. So it never dried in the end. Then I wanted to make some weeds and greenery using some translucent Primo Clay alcohol ink. And I did try some glow-in-the-dark powders. Now, my dad has it. I haven't asked him if anything's glowing. So I don't know if it actually worked. Something tells me I don't think it worked. I think you need to, it's better to kind of put the powder on the outside is my guess. I also used some fine thin wire to make the weeds or kelp. I don't know what kind of weed it is, but I laid the wire down, formed the weeds, and then kind of used my little, again, nail art tools are really great. I have a series of little fine tubes or small tubes in different sizes that make great little mini rollers. And then I made the little weeds with the translucent clay. As you know, if you work with polymer clay at all, translucent clay mixed with some alcohol ink, once it's baked, it has a nice translucence to it. I did lay them on Kleenex with some fiberfill on the bottom. I curled up the edges a bit, trying to create the most natural looking weed or seaweed that I could. And then I worked on some smaller ones without wire, just using shaping tools. And then I actually had ordered a bunch of glass cabochon type things in different sizes and pulled them out and started using them to shape some of my pieces on. So I made lily pads and some more kind of, not really weeds, but with the lily pads, I did need to make some of the root part that will hang down from a lily pad. I didn't look up how they really look. I just remember them when I was a kid and we lived in a place called Kenora on a lake. And I remember lily pads, which were really cool. So I made some little flowers and got everything ready in the oven, even made some homemade little polymer clay seashells, just random. Again, all of this was really whimsical. I didn't actually plan everything out. But then I decided I need a treasure box in there. Well, let me tell you, this jar was probably only about 3 by 3 inches and it got too packed. But hey, I didn't know that at the time. So I formed a little box out of construction paper with tape and then I made the clay sheets around it, tried to texturize it to make it look like wood. In the end, you can't see it, but my lid actually is probably about 1/4 inch too short. Here I thought I was so clever, but hey, you can't tell, trust me, when you see the end results. There, I baked everything in the oven on a ceramic tile in an oven, dedicated oven cake pan that I use, and I cover it with foil, as everyone recommends. That definitely, actually recently, this it'll be a mental note. If you notice things are scorching, check the temperature of your oven because our oven has recently gone up a bit and I noticed that. So I've been reducing the temperature of our oven. I threw in some fish, not the best fish sculpturer there is. It does make it easier to put it on a, I put it on a toothpick and then into some clay so it could stand up. And I was trying to think of, again, I was inspired by the miniature polymer clay artists and worked with kind of the ideas they had. There's one girl named Sugar Charm Shop, and she actually, they're so tiny and detailed. She actually here's all the pieces after they are baked. I pulled them off the glass. They actually, polymer clay and glass, ceramic tile. They, if you haven't worked with it at all, they work really well. They're oven proof. Now, remember, whatever you put on a shiny piece of glass or ceramic tile, well, the underside will be shiny, but it didn't matter because this is going in my little mini fish tank or aquarium. And I only actually used the starfish on the right that I made. I texturized it. The other one was just too big. Now, to texturize or sort of antique the treasure box, I did use acrylic paint where you spread on the acrylic paint like a dark color, and then I wipe it off right away. And it goes in all the cracks and crevices. That's why texturizing clay, you can get a really good effect afterwards. And then I made, anybody see Finding Nemo? Well, is this an anemone that I can't say either? Something like that, or a coral type life form in the water. I kind of just rolled out little cylinders, and then I put a toothpick type tool inside to create a tube, and then I placed them again on a glass stone. I also made some faux gold coins and treasure for my box and covered it with gold mica powder. You can't really see, the coloring is a little off, but it was more gold. It kind of looks a little green there, but it's actually kind of gold and shimmery. Adding shimmer, like mica powder with some shimmer to your fish, really help when it's in the resin, so you can sort of get that realistic look. And I thought, oh, I need some more jewels, so a crown jewel, so I'm made a very tiny crown, again, with gold mica powder, just on one of those nail art tubes, and just kind of lobbed it on, baked it, and it popped off. Well, it didn't pop off that easy. I had to work at it, but it's really tiny. That's probably only about less than half an inch. Then I made some more sickly-looking fish. I have to say, when I was placing them in, the biggest challenge was not having them appear belly up. And we've had aquariums. I grew up with an aquarium. Having a belly-up fish was not a good thing. So first, I made the first layer of epoxy resin, which is a two-part resin. You don't want to use UV for this. And I added a bit of alcohol ink to tint it, just ever so slightly, because I didn't want it to hide the details of the elements that were going in there. And then I just poured it in and placed the elements. And again, it was really tricky reaching into a tall jar for me. So yeah, not the best thing. And I got... being an artist, I don't know what it is, but I can't seem to stop. Less isn't more for me. I add and add and add, and then it ends up really cluttered. Now, because this is like faux water, having the bubbles appear is okay. It's natural looking for underwater, and is there you could actually see where the Mod Podge did not harden ever. So no matter how long I left it out, it just didn't harden. So yeah, so I did one layer. Then after I placed the pieces in, then I actually did a total of three layers. My epoxy resin was actually pretty old. I think it was the hardener. There's two parts, and one part can go yellow with age. And I thought for some silly reason that it would, just so you know, if you ever have that happen, it doesn't go clear. Right there you can see it's yellowed. So the second layer was just the resin I had with no food or no alcohol ink. The top layer had a bit more alcohol ink to tint it again. So it's not super realistic, but like I said, I was playing around, having some fun. It took probably about a week to do all this. I was working, I still ran out of time, as you'll see at the end. Yeah. So I can't stop taking pictures. I've got a problem. So I just want to share not all the pictures. I actually had to limit myself and edit this video so I wouldn't have every single picture that I took, but just really wanting to try to capture the details, because it was just really fun, and I highly suggest trying something like this. It's a great way to use a cool-shaped jar. I really like the jar. It was a square, and it tapers in and flares back out, and I don't know, I just really like it. I have about four of them, so that was the only thing I could think of doing with them. As you know, if you're working in polymer clay, you also like to cover anything that can be covered in polymer clay, so I kind of have that idea as well, but for now, it was a little mini, or not mini, I can't say mini, a little fish tank for my dad's 75th birthday, which is really cool. So, yeah. So I will stop talking now and just share some of the pictures. lily pads, I had to attach the root to the pad underneath, and then I placed it into the top layer of resin while it was still not when it was still fresh, because they would, I did lose one down there. I don't know if you could see it, but it did sink. So, oh, and there's, is that a fish that, yeah, I had a belly up. some dead looking fish. It was tricky. Like I said, using tweezers helps, but even then I still couldn't get at it very well. And it got heavier. The more I added, it just got too heavy for me to manage. So I bit off more than I can chew, but hey, it was fun. And, so it does take about a good 48 hours to really cure it until it hardens really well. Now, like I said, UV resin, a lot of people are using it. That's a whole different thing. Things won't cure properly. The UV light can't get to it. So epoxy resin works best. But again, like I said, if you want it totally clear, make sure it's not yellowed. And mine was pretty golden amber color. If it's slightly yellowed, it will dry pretty clear. But see, I marbled some clay. I made some fish right there on the above part there. The treasure boxes in there. Just kind of mixing clay and having some fun fish. Now, using translucent clay with the fish helped. Some look more cartoony, some look more realistic. But using the translucent clay sort of helps to create a bit of a more natural fish effect. Now there's some funky bubbles that I didn't plan on happening. Again, big experiment. Okay, that, hope you're not asleep. If you've made it to the end, way to go. Thanks so much. If you want to try this, yeah, let me know. I want to know how it goes. And I did make a lid. I covered the lid with clay. Unfortunately, it's upside down because I made a tinfoil form and yeah, said what his birthday and all that. But my dad showed up. I wasn't done. I had to hurry up. Then I totally forgot to take the final pictures. So I'm really sorry after all that. It's kind of anticlimactic. But you get the gist of it. So I hope if you like this that you can share and subscribe and all that fun stuff. And yeah, so thanks a lot for coming by.
Thanks for joining us today. If you want to stay in touch and get the most recent videos or blog posts as they happen, go to Facebook and look up Heartfully Creating Group and Heartfully Creating Page. And if you join us, you'll get up-to-date information as it happens. So happy creating. Thanks for watching.